Hey, I'm Chris, and in this Photoshop tutorial, I'm going to show you one of the best methods to put text on a surface that has some texture. I'm going to show the difference between using a blending mode and the blend if option, which is a very powerful tool in Photoshop, and you'll have the chance to decide which of the results you like more. I'm going to work with two photos for this tutorial. If you want to download them, the link is in the description. This is the first one with a jeans texture, and the second one is with this simple brick wall. I'm using this because there are some spaces between the bricks and the result will be really awesome and realistic. You'll see. So let's start with the first one. I already added some yellow text on two different layers here using the type tool. Actually, I didn't know what to write under jeans, so I searched on Google what year were blue jeans invented. I had no idea that they were invented in 1873. So I learned something new today, which is very cool. So in order to make this realistic, we need to make the fabric visible through the text. Some will say, oh, you just lower the opacity. Okay, let's do it. Let's lower the opacity to 70%. Does it look good? Not really. Let's put it back to 100%. Others will say, try the overlay or the soft-like blending modes. Let's put this on overlay. Here you go. But it doesn't look good at all. The jeans fabric is getting burned because of the bright yellow text layer on top. Also, the text became too faded. If we try with soft light blending mode, well, this looks even more faded. I can barely see the text now, and it doesn't give me that feeling of, hey, this looks real, it's awesome. No, it's still a fake look. So I will set these two layers back to normal blending mode. Now let's try with the blend if method. Before jumping into the blending options, I want to select each layer and convert it into a smart object because I will add some effects, some blending options, and by converting the layers to smart objects, I will have the ability to change the settings of all the effects that I'm going to apply. Let me just zoom in a bit to have the text on the whole working area, and now I right-click on the jeans text layer and choose blending options. First, I want to create some embossing for the letters, so I will check the bevel and emboss. For the depth, I will choose 80%, 16% for the size, and 9% for softness. You have to keep in mind that these values could be different if you're using another image. Our objective is to let the dark parts from the fabric to show up through the text. So to achieve this, we need to work with the blend if. So let's go back to the blending options. Make sure blend if is set to gray first, then focus on the underlying layer. So again, what do we want to show up on the text? The black areas from the material. So we take this slider and we drag it to the right side. You'll immediately notice that the dark areas from the jeans are starting to show up on the text. You'll see that the effect is harsh, so what I can do is to hold down Alt or Option and drag the left handle of the slider to the left. And look at this, it looks very good now. So keep in mind that these sliders can be split in two handles, and this helps you achieve smooth results. I will press OK here, and then zoom in very close to the margins of the letters. You can clearly see that the texture of the jeans is a bit blurred, while the edges of the letters are very, very harsh. So what can we do to fix this? We will apply a Gaussian blur. We go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. I already tested this, so for me, 5 pixels of blur will be enough. Before pressing OK, look at the before and after. Sharp edges, soft edges. Sharp, soft. Now we can say that the text is blending in very well with the jeans fabric. Just as a small trick, due to the fact that I converted the text layer into a smart object, I can go back anytime into the Gaussian blur. I just double-click it, change the value, and then hit OK. Smart objects are very, very powerful in Photoshop. Don't forget this. Okay, I press Ctrl or Command plus 0 to fit the image on the screen, and this text looks good now. All I have to do is to right-click the jeans layer, choose Copy Layer Style, then right-click on the second text layer, and choose Paste Layer Style. Everything was copied except the Gaussian Blur filter. To copy the filter with the same settings to the second text, I just hold down Alt or Option, I drag the filter here on the second text, and then I let go of the mouse. Now, both layers have the same settings and effects applied. And the final result looks very good and realistic. On the left, you can see how the text appeared when we used the blending modes. Overlay on top and soft light at the bottom. And on the right side, the blend if method, which in my opinion is the best. It's looking so good. Let's jump to the second image with the bricks. I want to show you one more example using the blend if panel. This time on one of the layers, I have a big white circle, and on another layer, I have a huge B from blend if. So let's say this is a logo that you want to apply on a brick wall. I will use the blend if on the white circle, and I will show you a nice little trick for the B letter. I right click on the circle layer and I convert it to a smart object, and I will do the same with the B letter. Then I will hide the text layer. I want to focus on the white circle only. So I right click the circle layer, choose blending options, and we have to deal again with this amazing option called blend if. Now think about it for a second. If you have a real brush in your hand and you start painting with white on this brick wall, you realize that you can't paint in those spaces between the bricks, right? And this is what blend if will simulate now, if I start dragging the dark slider to the right side. Something like this. And now, I can split these two handles apart to make the effect much softer. Okay, it looks very good. I will press OK, and let's make the text layer visible again. And here comes an awesome trick that you may not know about. So, I want the letter B to make a hole in the white circle. I want to see through the white circle and have the bricks coming through the letter B, like you see on the screen right now. So how do I do this easily? First, make sure the text is selected. You double-click the layer, choose blending options, and under advanced blending, you have an option called knockout. Choose shallow from this list and then hit OK. All I have to do now is to bring the mouse over the fill percentage, not the opacity, the fill, and drag it down to zero. Take a look at the B letter. We just did a knockout effect, and it's so awesome. If I zoom in, you'll see that the edges of the white circle and the text are too harsh compared with the brick wall sharpness, so I will select the white circle layer first and add a Gaussian blur filter to it. I choose 4 pixels and hit OK. I will apply the same blur to the text layer as well. Just hold down Alt or Option and drag the Gaussian blur effect on the text layer. I just copied the same Gaussian blur effect to the second layer. And now you can see how the text looked like before applying the blur and after the blur. This small detail creates realism to your editing, and it's very, very important. Here are the results if we were using the overlay and soft light blending modes versus the blend if option. Guys, if you want to learn more Photoshop, Lightroom, or Premiere, make sure you check out some other tutorials on my channel. I'm Chris. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.